Good evening and welcome back to Favorite Moments from Unstuffy and Unstoppable. The Symphony is back with a complete 5-concert subscription season. We'll be offering our traditional mix of great classics, opera favorites with stories from the stage, Broadway hits, and our annual Young Stars of the Future concert featuring this year's finalists. The brochure is in the mail, so keep a lookout for it. Tonight, we feature a variety of chamber ensembles from our symphony. You will hear performances from the principal players of our brass section, the symphony's percussion ensemble, the da capo players from our string section, and the symphony's woodwind quintet. In May, after COVID had closed down everything, we streamed a performance of the theme from Game of Thrones with our orchestra members at home. Here it is. The principal players from our brass section open up with a well-known fanfare from the opera La Peri by French composer Paul Dukas.
Thank you.
Now we feature the Da Capo players. The string quartet is made up of members from the symphony's string section. Here is the founder of the ensemble, Steve Velez, to tell you about their first selection.
Our first piece is called Joyful, Joyful. It's the melody that Beethoven wrote for his Ninth Symphony. We have performed that melody in so many different arrangements, but this one is very unique, very special, very high energy. You're going to hear that melody as if Coldplay intertwined with Beethoven. Towards the middle, you're going to hear sections of it that sound like we've taken a little bit of West Side Story and blended it in with Beethoven. Sit back, enjoy, and thank you again.
Now, the symphony's Woodwind Quintet performs the final movement from Anton Reicha's Woodwind Quintet in E-flat major.
Thank you.
The next performance is led by our former concertmaster, Luann Holmesy. I'll let her introduce her trio and selection.
Good evening, everyone, and thanks so much for joining us. My name is Luann Holmesy, and you may remember me from when I was concertmaster of the South Coast Symphony a few years back. I'm really excited because tonight I get to bring to you my band, Trio Dinicu, with Tommy Davy on guitar and Felix Kuchendorfer on double bass. We have a really exciting program, which consists of Eastern European music played in the Gypsy fashion. And we've accumulated this repertoire over the years, combination of listening to a lot of music, playing with Gypsy musicians, and then coming up with our own ideas. So we really hope you enjoy this evening's performance. Our first song is called The Whistle Hora, and it was composed by Grigoras Dinicu. Mr. Dinicu was a Romanian Gypsy whom were named after, actually, Trio Dinicu. And he was greatly admired by the virtuoso Yasha Heifetz because of his amazing technique, and also by the jazz violinist Stefan Grappelli because of his improvisational skills. So without further ado, here's The Whistle Hora.
Here again are the principal players from our brass section to perform variations on a French folk song, Frère Jacques.
Thank you.
In an earlier episode to celebrate St. Patrick's Day, we featured the Da Capo players in an evening of Celtic music. Here is their performance of a Celtic medley. For our final selection of the evening, we feature the symphony's percussion ensemble. They were nice enough to invite me to join them. Here is percussionist Matt Ordaz to tell you more.
The next piece we're going to play for you is A la Samba by Mitchell Peters. Peters was recently inducted into the Percussive Arts Society's Hall of Fame and has truly left an indelible mark on the world of percussion in many ways. As an accomplished performer in his own right, Peters served as principal percussionist in the Dallas Symphony Orchestra for 8 seasons before moving to California to serve as both percussionist and then principal timpanist of the LA Phil, an orchestra with which he performed with for 37 seasons. Mitchell Peters is perhaps best known for his extensive work in expanding percussion solo and ensemble literature, as well as creating a library of method books. His pieces and etudes are still used by colleges and university teachers across the globe, and his ensemble compositions are often a staple of percussion ensemble concerts. The piece we're going to play for you, A la Samba, written in 1969, is a groove-oriented sextet that brings Brazilian samba rhythms to the chamber music stage. Instrumentation includes xylophone, bells, güiro, marimba, triangle, timbales, bongos, and maracas. As you listen, I encourage you to hear how the two main themes sort of float along the sort of rhythmic river created by the non-tonal instruments. Please enjoy A la Samba. Thank you.
Next week will be the final episode in our favorite moments of Unstuffy and Unstoppable. It will be an evening of music from Broadway and Hollywood. So, until then, good night.